ॐ पूर्णमदः पूर्णमिदं पूर्णात् पूर्णमुदच्यते पूर्णस्य पूर्णमादाय पूर्णमेवावशिष्यते ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः शङ्करं शङ्कराचार्यं केशवं वादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वन्दे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः सो वेलकम अगेन ओपन द बुक द नंबर इज 83 आई चांट स्लोली एंड यू जस्ट फॉलो मी I go very slow. Anukshanam yat parhitya krityam anadya vidya krita bandha mokshanam deha parato ayam amusya poshane yasat jatesa shamanena hanti. I repeat. Anukshanam yat परिहृत्य कृत्यम अनादि अविद्या कृतबंध मोक्षणम देहा परार्थो अयम अमुष्य पोषणे या सज्जते शा श्रमणे न हन्ति सी द ट्रांसलेशन This body is essentially an instrument for realizing the Brahman. He who does not constantly use it for liberating himself from the bondage born of beginningless ignorance, but constantly seeks to gratify it, destroy himself. I repeat. Translation one more time. This body is essentially an instrument for realizing the self. He who does not constantly use it for liberation himself from the bondage born of beginningless ignorance, but constantly seeks to gratify it. Destroy himself. So now, new beginning. The question is, what the purpose of the body? What the purpose of the body? Body is an instrument for experience. Experience of misery, experience of happiness. Naturally, we want experience of happiness, but it is not possible. We have to experience miseries too, unwanted. These miseries are not our desire. They come unto us forcefully because misery and happiness complement each other. And without body, this experience is not possible. So, body is a must. for any experience, good or bad, anger or peace, any experience, body is a must. So without body, there is no experience. But now we are talking about especially human body. Other than human body, they supposed to are only for objective experience. But human body is not meant to for only objective experience. It is supposed to be more than that. So its purpose is very different. Shankaracharya says in sloka parartha. Parartha means, para means absolute, beyond. Artha means goal. So its first purpose is, human body's prime purpose is self-realization, experience, not objective experience, experience of self. It's experience of Brahman, consciousness. So Shankaracharya here used the word is parartha. Par means absolute. Objective word is not absolute. It is related. So our body is not for objective experience. This body is for parartha, absolute happiness. So the prime goal is human body's absolute happiness. You have to achieve absolute happiness, experience of absolute happiness, not only objective happiness. If we have body, so automatically we experience objective happiness and misery also. It will come. You will encounter worldly happiness and miseries because of our past life acts result. So worldly happiness, miseries will automatically come. It is not your goal, Shankaracharya says. It is not your responsibility. Your responsibility is, your goal is very high, supreme. So, anukshanam yat parehitya krityam anadya vidya krita bandha mokshanam. So we have to understand how to live in the world. What is Shankaracharya saying? It does not mean you neglect your body. It does not mean you destroy your body. So, deha pararthu. Do your duties with love, not with attachment. Enjoy your presence. You are here. You are so valuable. So enjoy your value, your presence, your expression in various form. in this world, live life, no problem. It's okay. What one thing we should always remember, that you are not here for here. You are here with very big challenge, very big task. And we have all equipments also. Your challenge is what? To be free from boundaries. The challenge is to be free from the boundaries. Your purpose is not the bodily. So first, our task is experience the supreme happiness. Then second task is the worldly life. He does not say that you neglect your body. He does not say you don't care your body, but you don't forget your target. So he says your target is anadi avidya krita bandha mokshanam, to be free from the world, to be free from the all boundaries. And which not doing such, he says he is destroying himself. I remember a story, very nice story in this context. There was a king in ancient time, and he was roaming interior parts of his kingdom to know about his people, how they live. So he was wandering, roaming, and he became alone, tired, thirsty, hungry, and slowly night was coming, it was going darkness. So he was looking a shelter of food, water, and he saw a villager is coming towards him. So king asked the villager, "I want to a shelter for night. Can you give me?" He said, "I do not know who are you. I am a very poor person. I have very small hut. It is also broken. I have not good food. But the guest is gone for us, so I cannot deny you. You come in my hut. Whatever is possible, I will serve you." So king went, and the poor person, without knowing he is a king, as a guest, he served everything, whatever possible he did, whatever food, water and shelter. In the morning, the king woke up and said to the poor person, "Look, I am the king of the state. And I am very happy. I am very happy by your service. So whatever you want, you can ask from me. I can give you. I am the key. He said, I am a very poor person. I don't have any idea. So please, whatever you like, you give me. I don't have idea what should ask from the king. Then king thought a little, some moment, and he said, I have a sandalwood garden, so I am giving you. And you use it properly, you will be a rich person. So king gave him the sandalwood garden. But the poor person did not know how to use the sandalwood garden, what the costs of sandalwoods, what the purpose. He was confused. Then he cut the trees and burnt it and made coal and sold in the market. He got some money. So after a few years, the king came back to see. He was hoping that the person would have been a rich person. So he came and he saw the poor person is still poor. He asked the poor person, what happened? I gave you so precious, so valuable, so lovable my garden. What did you do? He said, I cut the trees and I made coal and I sold in the market. I got some money. King said, oh my God, even God cannot help you. Because the sandalwood is so costly wood, you would have been a rich person. But you destroyed garden also, and still you are poor. The same story about us. God has given the human body. If you use properly, Shankaracharya says, then all boundaries created by ignorance, you can destroy. And who is not using the proper in this body, he says, Ya satyatesa samanena hanti, he is killing himself. He is killing himself. Now next one. Sharira poshanarthisan ya atmanam vidrikshati gram darudhya gritva nadim taratum sa gacchati. I repeat one more time. Sharira poshanarthisan ya atmanam vidrikshati graham darudhya gritva nadim taratum sa gacchati. The translation is, whoever seeks to realize the self by devoting himself to gratification of the body is like one who proceeds to cross a river holding on to a crocodile, mistaking it for a log of wood. I repeat one more time. Whoever seeks to realize the self by devoting himself to the gratification of the body is like one who proceeds to cross a river holding on to a crocodile, mistaking it for a log of wood. In previous verse, Shankaracharya shakes us. He shakes, wake up, wake up. What is your purpose in this world? And some people understood. And having known that the purpose of the body, is not only bodily objective happiness or misery. The human body's purpose is not only anger or peace. Its purpose is very big. Its purpose is only purpose is self-realization, not realization of objects. You have been given a task. If you have accept challenge half-heartedly, some people wake up and they start trying to be free from the bondage, those who are created by ignorance, and they start it, but half-heartedly. Shankaracharya says, they will not succeed. We have to understand that what is being said by Shankaracharya. It does not mean destroy your most valuable equipment. He does not say that it destroy your body. Shariram Atyam Kaludharma Shadhanam. There are scriptures are written, the body is the first means for spirituality. So don't destroy, don't neglect, but understand it is a very big equipment. But it does not also mean you are destroy yourself for the body. Understand clearly. You don't destroy your body. But it does not mean you destroy yourself for the body. Body is for you. For yourself. For realization. So use it. You are not for body. So we have to keep balance between means and goals. What is the goal and what is the mean? So body is as a mean, equipment, and self-realization is your goal. This is a spiritual practice. Spiritual practice means you are in body, and you are trying to go beyond the body. You are now as a body, and now we are trying to go beyond the body. Spirit. So, the seeker want to self-realization. And simultaneously, he is thinking about body, So Shankaracharya used the word is Sharir Poshanarthi. Sharir Poshanarthi. Very important word. He wants to be self-reliant. But he is devoted to the body. All time he is thinking about body. Everything, whatever he thinks, whatever he does, the center point is the body. Center point is the body. So, if body is the center point, and we want to be realized, Shankaracharya says, this is not possible. This is not, he wants, Shankaracharya wants, such seeker, who wants liberation, but they are not so serious. They are serious about body. Then Shankaracharya wants, he says, Graham daru dhiya gritva nadim taratu sagar gachat. What happens? Like he gave example, someone wants to cross a river. And for support, as equipment, we can use so many things. And the log of wood, very easily available. And its nature is floating on the water. So for support, we can take. Its nature is floating on the water. And so we take support and give the direction, we can cross the river. It is a way. Today, we are using like tube, plastic tubes. But in ancient time, they were using log wood. Very easily available, and it helps you. He gave example, the person wants to cross the river, and he goes to the beach of the river and saw a crocodile. Crocodile also can float on the river. Like a logwood. So mistaken, he takes support of the crocodile. Then what will happen? We can think. What will happen? Definitely, he will die. Definitely, he will going to die. So Shankaracharya says, Graham Darudhya Gretva Nadim Taratu Barchati. Like such seeker who is working half-heartedly, is not will go to liberation, he will destroy. Now next one, 85. Moha Eva Mahamrityu Mumukshoho Vapuradishu Moho Vinirjito Yena Sha Mukti Padam Arhati. I repeat, Moha Eva Mahamrityur Mumukshoho Vapuradishu Moho Vinirjito Yena Sha Mukti Padam Arhati. The translation is, for students seeking liberation with the body, etc., is it tragic death. He alone deserves liberation who has totally conquered this attachment. I repeat one more time. For student seeking liberation with the body, etc., is tragic death. He alone deserves liberation who had totally conquered this attachment. very directly, Shankaracharya now says, infatuation is tragic death. Infatuation. Death is not death. We, whatever death we understand, Shankaracharya denies. He says, this is not death. This is transformation. This is not death. Whatever death we know, whatever death we understand, Shankaracharya is not ready to accept as a death. Because just a transformation. What death means? He says, infatuation is a death. Because of infatuation, the seeker, the person, does not die one time. He dies so many times. So many times. Happy times. Moha eva mahamrityu. Moha means what? Think the word deeply. Moha, moha is, Sanskrit word is very important. What moha is? In Sanskrit, its root is moha. Moha means moha vaichitte. It means confusion. Your vision is not clear. Short-sighted. Almost like a blind. So what moha does, infatuation, what does? It does your vision cover. We cannot see what is the next. And we are like blind because of moha, because of infatuation. Do you remember what happened with Arjuna and Gita? He said, I cannot stay. My mind is wandering. And such Arjuna is the great warrior that time, greatest warrior that time. He said, I cannot stay. I lost my power because of infatuation. And what Krishna did? He did not change anything. The Bhishma was there before and after. Dronacharya were there before and after. So what Krishna did? He did only, he clears his moha. Nashto moha smriti labda. In the Gita and the verses, Arjuna says, Nashto moha. My moha, infatuation is gone. The main problem, Triyodhan was not problem, Bhishma was not problem, Dronacharya was not problem, any one was not problem. Problem was only moha. So before fighting, after fighting, nothing changed. Everything was same. Only one thing has changed. What? Moha. Arjuna said, Nashto moha smriti labdha. My moha, my infatuation has gone. Because the moha cover up your vision. You cannot take decision. Then whatever easy things comes, you accept. You don't want to solve problem. You want easy way. You want shortcut. we don't want solution. We don't want just achievement in worldly life and spiritual life also. We want a shortcut. So, Lord Shankaracharya says, Moha eva mahamrityu mumuksho bhagurādiṣu. So, this moha, infatuation, what does? It covers up your vision. And if your vision is not clear, and every time in this life also, not in spiritual life, in the worldly life also, every time, every day, every moment, you have to face new problems, new situations. You have to take decision, press every time. Tomorrow's decision will not come. They will not work. You take decision right now, according to this situation. So take proper decision. You have to a good vision, clear vision. Every time we have new challenges, solve these challenges, you have to face idea. Now he says, Bapuradishu. He gives some points where it starts. The starting point is Bapu. Bapu means body. It starts from the Bapu, from the body. It begins from the body, then go again, ahead, ahead, and limitless. So infatuation, passion start from the first point is body. Then it go beyond the body, relation, position, and then objective not matter. It may go in palace, it may go very uncostly object also. Objective not matter. It is not necessary there should be a place, a palace, a bell, a person. No. Because of ignorance, the infatuation anywhere can be, anywhere. So, moho vinarjitayena sa muktim padam arhati. He says, the condition is, you have to conquer the infatuation, and its roots are in ignorance. Its roots are in ignorance. Sa muktim pad marhati, only that person. It is not necessary you are a sannyasi, you are old age, you are fresh, youth, young, poor, king. No. Any condition will not work. Whatever you are sannyasi, you are a grass, no condition is applied. Only condition is Shankaracharya says, whoever conquered the attachment, the person deserved for liberation. Now next one. Moham jahi mahamrityum dehadar shuta dishu yam jitva munayo yanti tad vishnu paramam padam. I repeat again. Moham jahi mahamrityum dehadar suta dishu yam jitva munayo yanti tad vishnu paramam padam. The meaning is, conquer this great attachment to your body, wife, children, etc. By conquering these, sages reach the supreme state of Lord Vishnu. I repeat, conquer this great attachment to your body, wife, children, etc. By conquering these, sages reach the supreme state of Lord Vishnu. Now Shankaracharya directly says Jai. Jai means as an order. Do like you do. Shankaracharya says conquer. In previous verse he said tragic death. Tragic death. Repetition of the death, not one time. So he says, now come explaining what is the meaning of conquering. Shankaracharya wants the infatuation is your energy. And it is resides in your insight, always with you. And strangely, you always support. Your support is his strength. You always support. And obviously, you are not doing it knowingly. It happens unknowingly, your support but goes to him. Because we are in ignorance, unknowingly we are supporting our infatuation, our enemy, greatest enemy. Lord Sri Krishna said, Arjuna, just know your enemy. Your enemies are not outside. They are enemy for some times. Today's enemy, tomorrow may be friend. Today's friend, tomorrow may be enemy. So they can change. Outside is not fixed. Everything is changed. Enemy may be become friend, friend become enemy. But you have an enemy in your insight. And you always support. Unknowingly, he says, be alert, understand, shake yourself, open your eyes. You are always constantly supporting your great enemy. Lives and lives. Any object is not your enemy. Any person is not enemy or friend. Only thing is makes change. This is attachment. Attachment make them problematic. Only thing is not problem. Person is not problem. The realized person also lives in this world. He has no problem. He enjoys everything. Janak can live in palace without any problem. Ashtavakra can live in forest. Dattatreya can live in the forest. Krishna can live in a palace. So palace and forest is not problem. The enemy is inside. Shankaracharya says, identify. Yam jitva munayo yanti tad vishnu paramam padam. Whoever understand, so first you understand you identify your enemy, you are always supporting. Identify, this is not your friend, this is your enemy, greatest enemy. So identify, and you have to conquer. You understand this, it's reality. And what Shankaracharya, what use here? Munayaha. Yam jitva munayo yanti. Munayaha, the very typical words. Munayaha, here is shloka. Na maunan munir bhavati, na ranya vasnan muni. Svatattam tu yeva vetti sa munayo padam ikshat. Munay means what? Muni means, we have concept, Muni means who lives in the forest. Scriptures know. In their forest there are so many types, animals also. They are not Muni. They are criminals also, they are not Muni. They are tribals, they are not Muni. So only living in the forest, one cannot be a Muni. Another concept is, who has keep silence? Scriptures know, na maunan, only silence cannot make you Muni. Only definition is, svatattvam yaveti, the self-realized person is the Muni. Muni means self-realized person. So Shankaracharya used the word, Munayo yanti tat dishno paramam padam. So after conquering, having conquered the infatuation, the Muni, the sages, now deserve to achieve Vishnu paramam padam. Here Vishnu means supreme consciousness. In scriptures, Vishnu means omniscient. Vishnu means omnipresent. Vishnu does not mean only forehand, sankh, chakra. Yes, the shape is also, the form also the Vishnu. But in this context, Vishnu is the supreme consciousness. So the sage will go to supreme reality. Now last one. Tvangman sarudhir snayu medu majjasti sankulam Purnam mutra purishabhyam sthulam nindyam idam vapuhu. I repeat. Tvangman sarudhir snayu medu majjasti sankulam Purnam mutra purishabhyam sthulam nindyam idam vapuhu. The meaning is, the gross body is most offensive as it is composed of skin, flesh, blood, vessels, fat, marrow and bones. And also it is ever filled with urine and stool matter. I repeat, the gross body is most offensive and it is composed of skin, flesh, blood, vessels, fat, marrow and bones. And also it is ever filled with urine and stool matter. Here the question is, why Shankaracharya explaining body in gross level? It's a very practical. Anybody can recognize it. Anybody can see its fact. What gross body is? Now started topic is, what gross body is? What is reality? I told once that our scriptures does not condemn any object and does not praise any object. They just tell truth. They just tell truth what real is, what reality is. Their intention is not condemning or praising any object. So Shankaracharya says, you know what gross body is. It appears beautiful. But if you think, and this matter not just thinking, little think, you can realize that very simply, nothing is beauty. And this method is very scientific. If someone wants to know what body's reality is, he can know very easily. He can understand very easily. But problem where is where? Now see, the physicians, the doctors, surgeons, they know everything about the body. They know everything about the gross body. They know its in and out. What is inside? And they know that nothing is beautiful. You can put an elephant tooth in your drawing room, but you cannot put your tooth, your drawing room, your showcase. Elephant's tooth is better than our tooth. We can use deer skin, tiger's skin for meditation, but we cannot use human's skin for anything. So there are some animals, their body parts they can use and they look not so ugly. But in human body, nothing is beautiful. Where is the beauty? In blood and marrow? Where? If nothing is beautiful, then how they can make a beautiful body? So doctor, physician, they know everything about the body, every part of the body. They know. But their knowledge is not understanding. They know it practically. They know it theoretically. In the body, there is nothing a beauty. But see, they don't understand. Having known that the reality of the body, they are not dispersed with the body. They are attached to the body. Why? Then their knowledge just information. Their knowledge just information. Their knowledge not understanding. So Shankaracharya tried to make us understand. Doctors can know the reality of the body, but they are not dispersed from the body. The seeker, that is why Shankaracharya is trying to tell the reality of the body. He wants to make us understand and digest the knowledge. So doctor know, but don't understand. So this is different. That is why Shankaracharya trying to here explain about body. Otherwise, there is no purpose. So he says, nothing is beauty. So think deeply. and you understand the reality, then dispersion will come. So today we are staying here. Thank you very much. Om Purnamadaha Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi. Shankaram Shankaracharyam Keshavam Vadarayanam Sutra Bhashya Kritau Vande Bhagavantau Puna Puna Isharu Guru Ratmeti Murti Veda Vibhagine Vyomavat Vyakta Dehaya Dakshina Murtaye Namaha. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti.